Tesla CEO Elon Musk has signed on to a letter pledging his company's commitment to China's quote core socialist values in order to continue operations in the world's most populous country. Chinese authorities had demanded that electric vehicle automakers alter their behavior after Tesla and others in the industry slashed their prices last year in order to choke out smaller competitors, which Chinese officials characterized as reckless. About a third of Tesla's sales come in the Chinese market, and Tesla was the only non-Chinese firm to sign onto the letter, according to the Financial Times. Musk has become a kind of hero on the American right, as we know, since purchasing Twitter last year, which he has promised to turn into a haven for free speech. But the billionaire executive's business entanglements with China have threatened that status. During a trip to China last month, Musk described the United States and China's economies as conjoined twins and expressed opposition to efforts to decouple the world's two major powers. Musk has praised the Chinese regime for, quote, the economic prosperity, close quote, that it has achieved in Twitter replies to state media accounts, and told the Financial Times last year that he believes Taiwan should be controlled by the Chinese Communist Party as a special administrative zone. The suggestion was quickly celebrated by Chinese ambassador to the United States, Qin Gang. People on Twitter who normally have a very calm, rational response to things flipped out. How can you denounce a woke mind virus one day and then turn around and pledge to the Chinese government you will uphold core socialist values? Asked National Review's Jim Garrity. Self-proclaimed free speech absolutist Elon Musk's Tesla has joined Chinese automakers in pledging to enhance core socialist values, a term that generally denotes not criticizing the Chinese government, observed Media Matters Matthew Gertz. So there's a little more of the story in a moment, but I would love to hear my co-host takes on this. Cenk?
Yeah, so first of all, I love the story because it gets the right wing to accidentally look into their own beliefs, right? So they're like, Elon Musk is right wing god. He's gonna let us say all these right wing things, whether they're hateful or not. I love that guy. Core socialist values. I do not like socialists. I don't know what it means. I've never even bothered to look it up in a dictionary, but I know I hate it. Oh, does not compute, love Elon, hate Elon, does not compute. I love to see that, right? And to be fair, the right wing, no one in media ever defines what socialism is. Almost, not just the right wing media, but mainstream media are always talking about socialism and usually spit right afterwards. They're like, socialist, Bernie said, right? And they're like, wait, you didn't even say what it was. And do you mean socialist as in communist? Like North Korea, which is just a dictatorship? Or do you mean socialist like Finland? Because Finland's pretty lovely. Denmark's like the happiest place on earth, literally, right? So what do you mean socialist? So I like that their heads are exploding, trying to figure out for the first time in their lives what words mean, or at least that particular word. But I have to be honest with you guys. Is Elon Musk a socialist? No, he signed on to the core socialist values so he can sell more Teslas in China, which is ironically very capitalist.
Yes, that's perfect. I was actually gonna point out, like, other than China's government being all encompassing and all up in everybody's business and being above the law, the country itself economically is extremely capitalist. Otherwise, they wouldn't have got where they are so quickly, let alone the fact that they have thousands of year history, what have you. But you pointed it out, Elon Musk is just trying to make money. And it always cracks me up because Elon Musk has always been a deeply unserious and ridiculous person. Ideas of putting people on rockets that have a 1 in 100 chance of exploding to travel around the world faster. 1 in 100 chance of exploding means a whole lot of people gonna die. And your rockets be exploding every time you try to go to the moon. So, Elon Musk is just a deeply unserious man, the whole Twitter debacle, whatever. He's gonna continue to do whatever he can to keep his brand alive and to save himself financially. But essentially, all Elon Musk really is a mascot. The genius Jimmy Neutron who's gonna save the world from everything. Clearly, that's not who he is. His brand continues to crumble. But, I just love seeing anytime Elon Musk's legacy and legend just gets shown to be a complete lie, because it is.
And he's a confused man as well, despite or in the face of this very confused legacy. Because obviously we all know he is a pretty right-wing man these days, said he supports DeSantis for president, helped launch his campaign disastrously, but has previously posted on Twitter that he is a socialist back in 2018. Quote, by the way, I'm actually a socialist. Just not the kind that shifts resources from the most productive to least productive. Pretending to do good while actually causing harm. True socialism seeks greatest good for all. Musk, who also owns Twitter and SpaceX, traveled to China last month and met the foreign commerce and industry ministers, as well as Robin Zeng, founder and chair of CATL, the world's biggest maker of EV batteries. His trip returned the spotlight to restrictions on free speech that have intensified under Xi. Twitter is banned in China, and Musk refrained from using the platform during his visit, drawing criticism from human rights groups over allegations of compliance with Chinese censorship. And again, sure, that could be him just worrying about his car sales, but for frame of reference, it is super easy to use Twitter from China. You just get a VPN app. I performed a bunch of comedy shows in Shanghai, China a few years back, and I tweeted up a storm. I risked getting in trouble, did it anyway, but I didn't have as much to lose economically, and you know, getting arrested in China might have been interesting for my life story. Tesla's commitment to core socialist values and Musk's absence from Twitter while in China appear to clash, at least in spirit, with Musk's 2022 description of himself as a free speech absolutist, according to the Financial Times. And this latest episode is the latest reminder of the tightrope many multinationals must walk amid increasing assertiveness from the Chinese government and hawkishness in their home markets. In recent years, accusations of obeisance to Beijing have hit countless companies, from HSBC and Nike to the hotel group Marriott and car company Daimler.
Yeah. So, guys, I think that Elon back in 2018 called himself a socialist because he grew up in another country, whereas he grew up in South Africa. So, in the rest of the world, the word socialist is not scary. It's not, doesn't mean the same thing that it means here in America, because it doesn't mean anything here other than what the like scary stuff that media can stuff into it and Republicans can stuff into it. So in growing up in South Africa, probably being a socialist was super normal, as it is in a great majority of the world. Now, if you think socialism equals communism, first of all, you're wrong, because they're literally two different concepts and two different words. But in America, that's how it's often confused. So they're like, oh, and in fact, with China, they'll say the Communist Chinese Party. I can't believe Musk is he's a socialist. It's gonna go to China, and they're gonna wait. If they're such socialist/communist, why did they let him sell Tesla there? I'm pretty sure Tesla's a private company, and I'm sure that when you buy it, you own your private car. Oh, right, because all these words are meaningless. And as Jackson pointed out, China is now largely a capitalist country, but one with central planning and largely basically a dictatorship. But it ain't got nothing to do with communists.
Yeah, 100%. And my last point is, you know, Elon Musk, for him to be, you know, the right wing's American ideological hero, like, he's not even from here, which makes it even more ridiculous, because he doesn't really have anything in the fight. He doesn't have any skin in the game, for real. He's an international businessman. He's gonna do whatever he needs to do, just like Napoleon. Every time he went anywhere, he pretended to be Muslim. When he conquered Egypt, he go here, he pretend to be, anywhere he goes, it's no different. So, you know, the man from South Africa, he's the American ideological political hero for the right, which is an oxymoron.
If that's where he's really from, I think he'll get right back to people on Mars one day.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.